Next case, Muammar al-Gaddafi is dead. The future of Libya, unknown. Question, should the US taxpayer help foot the bill for rebuilding Libya? Dr. Zuhdi Jasser is with us. He is the founder of the American Islamic Forum for Democracy. He joins us live from Phoenix. Doctor, it's always a pleasure to have you with us, and thanks for joining us again.
Thank you.
It's
a pleasure, Stuart. Thanks for having me.
I believe you think that the American taxpayer, we Americans, should help with the rebuilding of Libya. Is that your position?
Well, my position, Stuart, is that it is in our interest, both from a national security perspective and from an economic perspective, that we have some role in helping the right people. Because if we don't, we really don't have a choice, because isolationism and withdrawal is going to really allow the Islamists to take over, to hegemonize the Middle East, and we will pay a price for it either in the short term or the long term from a security perspective. Not to mention that we're already providing some aid to the area, so why not do it in a more intelligent way rather than just throwing cash to the area?
Well, look, there's an obvious counter-argument to that, and it's going to come right back at you from the American people. Look, Libya has only 4 million people. It's capable of exporting oil with a value of at least $100 million a day. There's nothing poor about Libya. Why do you need our money? Besides which, we're broke. I mean, you counter that argument, please.
Well, Stuart, the counter to that is that we're dealing with a battle of ideas. The Middle East is going through the same transformation that Europe went through before the creation of America. There's a battle with the secularists who are like our organization that want to separate mosque and state versus the Islamists or the secular fascists that want to continue to take over those countries and rule it by oppression and
thugocracy. I've got to jump in. The premise of your argument is that we can buy friends, that if we fund some reconstruction, it will work and keep the Islamists out. There's no guarantee of that.
You're right. No, we're not just funding reconstruction. We are helping them with their own interests. There are groups that want to separate mosque and state. There are liberty-minded groups that want to believe in freedom and build newspaper organizations, journalistic, universities, academia, etc., to begin to rebuild a free environment. We see this not only in Libya, in Syria, in Tunisia, and elsewhere. I mean, what happened in Libya, now we have to realize, is going to spread even further, and hopefully will spread to Syria. And we saw a shot in the arm with the opposition, but yet they need help. We can't be absent, Stuart. We have a role to play in the push for liberty.
But look, they can get $100 million a day from their oil exports. Where does that money go to? Where does that go to?
It's going to go to continued tribal leaders, thugs, and Islamist interests that are going to continue to use that petrodollars as it has in the last, as Jim Woolsey, the former head of the CIA, said, the Islamists have had a $90 billion head start. All of those petrodollars are not, if it was going to go, Stuart, to help free-minded institutions, they would have a flourishing, a plethora of universities based in freedom and free thinking, and we don't see that. The secular groups have not had an infrastructure. They're going to need our help, no different than Eastern Europe needed our help, even though they had their own resources.
Take your point, Doctor, but it's a very difficult point to make, because we are broke and we're being asked to pay for the freedom of others, the roads for others, the universities for others, when we ourselves can't do it here in America. That's a tough road to hoe. But go ahead. Last word. You've got 10 seconds, sir. Last word.
Well, it's an investment that's worth it, and it's an investment that in the past has always shown in the West that it works, and it's worth our time and energy, and will pay off not only in the Middle East but domestically and abroad to help us in security and help us with helping the right people.
You're an articulate spokesman for your point of view, and we appreciate you delivering it today. Dr. Zuhdi Jasser, thanks very much, sir. I want to ask our audience,
what do you
think about this? Varney at foxbusiness.com, weigh in on it, please. Interesting subject. More big names that you know. GNC.